The book, it's flying. We're over the moon with how it's doing. And we didn't realise when we first released it last month just how much it was needed.
Yeah.
How much of a hunger there was for a book like this internationally. You know, I've had teachers in Washington writing to me saying, we're bringing this into our school and we're sharing it around the faculty because the teachers and the parents that want to help these young LGBT kids, they just don't have the tools. They don't know how do we uplift this child.
OK. So, Iraqi Muslim dad.
Yeah.
Tell us about the conversation. Did you sit down and say, Dad, I've got something to tell you?
No, I couldn't say it.
How old were you?
I was 17. And Mom found out about 9 months before. So her and I built this kind of, you know, duo partnership of secrecy. How do we keep it from Dad? Because we were just very afraid of the way he'd react. And when it came to the night when I told him, my mom was the one who suggested it. I couldn't get the words out correctly. And I just took a book off the counter, a school book, and tore the back page and wrote the words, I'm gay on it, slid it across the table. And then things sort of went a bit mad. It took him a good few weeks to sort of come around and learn what it means.
What was his initial reaction?
Oh, well, shame. Absolute shame. How are we going to tell the family? How are we going to tell friends? Was it a failure in him as a father that, you know, made me gay? And now, obviously, he knows that it was nothing to do with him. Actually, it was biological. Something or someone else decided to give me what I call in the book a gift. And that's exactly what it is. And he, you know, we went through a really, really dark patch of, you know, he at one point considered taking his own life. And we speak very, very openly about that because we want to show parents around the world who are struggling to accept their beautiful LGBT child, want to show them that it can be a sting, it can be a shock, it might even feel like a bereavement, that you've lost this beautiful person you've made, but actually they're exactly the same. If anything, they're better because they're now authentic, they're free, they're open, they're happy.
How old were you when you knew you were gay?
I believe it was around 12 years old. You start to look at, I remember Aladdin was my first crush. he's very handsome, you know what I mean? And I have got, you know, Arabic blood in my body. So he was my little prince. And I used to hate Jasmine because she was taking him away from me. and then it progressed from there to, you know, looking at guys in my school class and just admiring their beautiful hair or their skin. And it was as simple as that. And you go through what I call in the book, the PCO, the pre-coming out stage, which for me and most young people is about 4 years. And during those 4 years, you battle with yourself trying to accept this difference that exists within you. And you believe that it's an affliction, it's a sickness, and it's something that needs to be weeded out. And, you know, I remember thinking back then that if there was a pill that I could have taken that would have made me straight, give me 10 of them, let's go. But now, after being educated and learning to love myself and having a fantastic accepting family and a beautiful boyfriend, there's no way
I'd take the pill. Celebrated your anniversary, haven't
you? Yeah, 1 year. Yeah. We just moved in together. So come back to me in a month and we'll see.
And as far as your dad's concerned, he's accepted you to such an extent. I mean, I see it on your social media all the time. Mm. I mean, you can't get a fag wrapper between you, but he's also written a piece of the book, hasn't he?
Yeah. And you know, when I went to him and I said, look, you have been through a journey, Dad, that is very, very unique. I can't write this on your behalf. What it was like to go through that turmoil in your head and then eventually decide to put your love above shame. And there was no question for him. Instantly, yes, 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 we'll do it. So Mom and Dad together wrote this gorgeous chapter, which is emotional, very frank, very honest. And at the start of the chapter, I say to the young person reading the book, you know, you've gotten this far, now hand it over to Mom and Dad and let them sort of absorb.
So what do you want people to take away from the book? It's called Yeah, You're Gay, Now What? A Gay Boy's Guide to Life.
Well, it's in the title. It's that this is a reason to celebrate. You know, being gay, being LGBT in general is...
Is there still a stigma?
Oh, hugely.
Is there?
We're in this, you know, beautiful city, London, and we expect that we're incredibly liberal and open, but still, I walk down the street holding my boyfriend's hand and you get called names, you get jeered at, you get stopped in tubes, you know, by people who don't accept. So our little, small, private, romantic moment is turned into a political statement. You don't want it to be that. Mm. So, you know, it's difficult, but we're getting there. And look at Ireland, for example, you know, 1993, well, yeah. It was decriminalised. I was 2 years old and it was still illegal to be gay. Mm. And we've gay Taoiseach now. So legally and in government, we've come along in strides, but society needs to change. And I believe that starts in schools with LGBT education.
And certainly the book is written in a way where young men and women of all ages can pick it up and think, oh, OK, yeah, that is me. Oh, and that's what I potentially should do next. What was the best advice that you received in order to be able to help you be you?
You are enough as you are. Nothing needs to be altered, changed, fixed or removed. Mm. You are a gorgeous young human, and that I needed to stop putting an onus on acting and contorting my voice and my bodily movements to appease the people around me. But actually what I needed to put my time and effort into was my passions, my family, my loves, nature, the things that I was interested in. And the minute I let go of all of the shame and the shackles of society and what I was expected to be like as a young boy, this, you know, masculine, the minute that went, I started to live. Mm. I wasn't living, I was coasting. And that so many of these LGBT kids, they're in school, but they're surviving, they're not learning. They're going in and they don't want to be there because they know that the next day it could be a disaster. And the figures say it all. You know, these are Irish figures, but they're directly comparable to the UK. LGBT kids are 2 times more likely to self-harm, 3 times more likely to consider taking their own life, and 4 times more likely to suffer from severe anxiety or depression. They're cold, hard facts. That's not made up. And we're not just going through a situation where these kids are finding it difficult. We are losing young people. They are dying right now in this country. It's not okay.
No, it's really not.
And it starts with bullying. So a book like this is just as much for the LGBT kid as it is for the straight kid who needs to know that it's not okay to be mean to them. It's not okay to be rude to them.
I saw your friends messaging you saying, I can see you on the TV.
Yeah, I know. Sorry about that. God. You know, TV 101, don't bring your phone on set.
What is your top bit of advice? You wrote on the back of a school book and handed it over to your dad. What's your top bit of advice to tell your parents? Because I'm guessing it's most important to tell your parents first.
No, not necessarily. Okay. I actually say in the book, you find a coming out guinea pig.
Okay.
Someone who's kind of close, but who isn't actually attached to your family. They can't bring it home.
Okay.
And before you tell your parents, make sure you've got things set up that in the event that there's a bad reaction, you can get the 3 main things still. That is food, a roof over your head and school. But be gentle with them, okay? This is new to them. You've had those 3-4 years to figure it out yourself. They're going to get this news in a second. So, you know, give them a chance to learn slowly and to accept it. And they will hit you with certain things that are offensive. That's just the nature of it. Mm. But in time, they'll learn.
OK. You really do need to get...
But at least it's on silent, huh? Yeah, high five.
That's brilliant. Yeah, high five. And so the book is called Yay, You're Gay. Now What? A Gay Boy's Guide to Life. Riyadh contacted me on social media, said, can I come on the show? And I said, yeah, but he didn't invite me to his book launch.
I'm sorry, but I didn't think you'd come.